going out there? I'm Zach Burtz. I'm a senior welding instructor here at Tulsa.
I'm Shane Murphy, a senior welding instructor at Tulsa.
And I'm Brian Akers, senior instructor from Tulsa Welding School in Jacksonville, Florida.
We got a about 220 welding booths out here at Jacksonville Campus. We're open 15 hours a day. We run 3 shifts.
You got morning, afternoon, night. You can actually come in off your shift and get a little bit more practice.
We have class days 3 days a week.
Starting phase 1, we start working on stick welding, just kind of teaching you how to strike up, how to be able to run a consistent bead on a plate in several different positions.
And we actually work our way up. It gets more difficult every phase that we do. The next phase is going to be vertical T plates. It's a little bit more difficult, and then we go to overhead. And then our next phase,
yeah, it's a periodic transition from structural all the way up to pipe, starting in phase 5. And then you learn how to TIG weld in phase 6. And when you get to my class, phase 7, I teach you how to walk the cup on a 2-inch pipe like we ran in some of the demos. This is Shane Murphy. I'm Brian Akers. We're going to do something a lot of people do. I'm going to feed the wire while he walks the cup. So I'm going to strike the arc and everything like we're doing a combo weld. You ready? Anytime people come here, we are glad to help them out, no matter what the weld is.
You can take this trade.
This is all you, dog.
Oh man, you can take this trade as far as you want to go with it. Main thing is you just got to kind of find what you're really good at, put in all your time. It's all about hood time, just being here every day. Attendance is key. Giving your all while you're here, you know, until you get out of here and we get a good job and decide which way we want to head.
That's exactly it. If you don't put the dedication in, it's just like anything. The more practice you get, the better you're going to get.
Yep.
I mean, we tell our students all day long, if you stay in that booth and you weld all 5 hours, like me personally, when I went to school here 7 years ago, I actually stayed in the booth for 10 hours every day. I would come in off my shift, get a little bit extra practice in, and it makes you more successful for sure.
Yeah, as we go through the school, there is also available Phase 11, which is done through me, myself, and Career Services. We teach you an extracurricular activity for specific jobs. I had a job last week to come in here for students. They were looking to hire tube welders. The beauty of it is they make $27 an hour, $110 a day per diem. That was a good thing for them. And is just for us to do that, to teach people, that's where our job is more valuable to me, other than anything else. Even being in the field, this is way better because I enjoy what I do, and I'm sure these guys do. Shane, he went to school here where he was one of my students. He was one of the first graduating classes. So, I mean, it just speaks for itself.
Yeah. Full circle. Just got to come in here, put in your time, learn the trade, hands down,
yes.
And you will be successful.
And we are here to teach you know, and that's what we love to do. Like Brian was saying, we don't want to be out in the field doing our own thing. We'd rather be in here to get you to where you need to be so you can go out in the field and make that money.
Yep. We have guys that come to school here that started off never welding to guys that do have experience, and all age groups, from high school students all the way up to people that could be our fathers or whoever that wants to learn the trade. It doesn't matter. We're here for them, and that's what we service for these guys, to learn how to weld.
We'll be waiting on you.
That's right. Good luck. We look forward to working with you.
Yeah, hope to see you soon.
This is what we call plant jacks. This was designed 100% by the instructors here at Tulsa. From the ground up, it was built, and the thought went into how can we create a pipe fitting program that'll benefit the students, so when you graduate, you'll be able to not only weld the pipe, but fit the pipe, okay? So the course contains 4 phases, 3 weeks each phase. So you have to graduate the welding side before you could take this add-on program. This program is relatively new. We started it in, I believe it was March timeframe, and we're up and running full speed, and we've already graduated 3 classes out of here. Okay, what this does for you is makes you more marketable and more, you know, to an employer when you sit down and talk welding or fitting. It opens up 2 different doors, or a lot of times if you're looking on the internet, it'll say welder fitter combination. That's what they're looking for, and that's what you'll be. Okay, so what that means to you is it could mean a little bit more in your pocket in the paycheck, because you can do both. And maybe sometimes if work gets light, you get to stay on, because you can do both, you know. And it's just like going to a store and you want to buy one, get one. Employers are the same way. I want to buy one and get one, right? It's a better deal all the way around. So what you see set up out here is set up just like you would see at similar job sites. This is our phase 4, final phase before you graduate. And everything that you learn inside in the lab, you'll come out here and apply. Different scenarios, a 5-inch pipe, these 3 back here, you'll learn butt welded fittings, threaded pipe, and bent pipe. Okay, and I teach all that in phase 2 and 3. And then you'll come out here, what you'll do is you'll get your assignment, your test. It's all 100% test out here from start to finish. We don't practice out here, practice is inside. So let's say you got to do this 5-inch one. All right, this won't be here. What'll be here will be this flange and that flange down there, and nothing in between. You'll have a piece of paper that has it all laid out for you, minus the measurements. That's on the student to pull the measurements, figure out what he needs as far as material, get it all, bring it out here, set up your stands, set up what you're going to cut with, and then start your assembly. So you'll take your first overall measurements, and then you'll come up with your cut lengths, which you learn in the welding side how to do your takeoffs. Same thing applies here. You learn how to do your takeoffs so that you can cut the right length of pipe. Make all your cuts, make your bevels, and then you start assembly. When you're done with the assembly, then I'll come out and grade it out. Of course, if you need help along the way, I'm always here. But by the time you get out here, I'll have the confidence in you that I don't have to be out here. That's the goal. The goal is that you get, just like if I'm an employer and you're my employee, here's your assignment for the day, get your stuff, knock the job out. That's how it works out there. You know, your employer is not gonna be walking around, you know, holding your hand. So we wanna set you up for success by making you independent in this craft. Just like in the welding side, when you're done phase 10, you know, you're pretty much on your own. You know what's expected, you know what to do, and you just do it. And that's what employers want. They want you to be able to come out here, do what they want done in a timely manner, efficient, minimal mistakes. I mean, everybody makes mistakes, so, you know, that happens. But what we want is to get you as close to perfect as we can. I mean, 20, 30 years down the road, I mean, may not be perfect. You know, I'm not perfect, make mistakes. But it's how you recover from those mistakes that will cost your employer minimal amount of time lost, minimal amount of material lost. Okay, because we all know a mistake is going to get made. It's how we recover from that, and I teach that here. Okay. Because as students, you'll make a mistake. But you learn more from your mistakes than what I show you on a chalkboard. Okay, so we make a mistake, we sit down and we figure out why we made that mistake, how we made it, how we recover from it. Okay, so that's what this is totally set up to do, is to get you ready to call that employer and say, I'm ready for an interview, I'm ready to come work for you. Yeah. That is my goal. Out here, we have to put grades on stuff, but grades are not that important out here as to do you get it, okay? Because your resume will get you an interview. Your interview will get you the job, but what you learn here will keep that job. That's my goal. Get you in the door, get you working, and teach you how to keep that job in this industry.